Hello everyone, this is Chinmay from Ekado Clinic. Welcome back to our show. This time also you guys are going to help me out a lot now. In my last video, or maybe video is in schedule or something, we have done cone set fitting job in Thunderbird. This time I'm going to show you how to do it in standard, in UC engine only, but it's a standard chassis. So this procedure is almost applicable for even old bullets, that is cast iron or AVL, or old, very old bullet as well, because it's been almost same procedure what they have, or the construction what they have given. Due to that, our procedure is constant. Only one of the generation is different, because the fork was different in one of the generation, that is old. The top portion of the fork was having thread. In this generation there is no thread, there is only one different kind of a bolt. So half of the procedure I am going to show you. Remaining procedure you can follow according to the Thunderbird only, because it is just removal of front wheel, fender and other things. But yes, definitely half portion I am going to show you in this video. So Devosis is here as usual with us, and it's almost 11:30 at night. And we have to start this work now, because we have to do the recording as well for you guys, and we have to deliver this bike immediately in the morning. So we will just try to cover up this job right now. We had nice ample dinner, so now we are energized, and Devosis is very much excited to do this job. So Devosis now will open front wheel, then the fender, then the fork, and some of the things which are very regular, but other things which require recording, in that case I will show you time to time. In standard bike, the pinching bolt is kind of this is the pinching bolt. If you dismantle, or if you just loosen this bolt, then the axle can come out of the wheel. Older bikes, that was like standard engine, or we can say cast iron engine, those bikes were having caps, fork caps, so it was a different construction. So this construction is came in the market say after 2005 or 2006. So this is a very simple construction what they did. So here in this case engineers have done a very good job. So apart from this section, everything is almost same in standard chassis. This is the, as you can see, I know light is very less here because we are almost half outside now, so it's quite cold outside and quite hot inside, so we are in a dilemma where to do the job. But we are trying our level best to remove the assembly for you guys also, and we have to cover the job. So this is the Allen fork top bolt which we'll be removing. In older bikes there was a thread inside for the headlight dome as well as for the fork. So stay connected guys, I'll try to show you all the details. Some of the details, as I said, I will show you, but not 100%, because common things I won't be able to catch up in this video. So we have removed the all fender bolts. Remember one thing, there is a timing in this particular bike, there is a timing for the speedometer hub assembly that I will show you. In fact, I'm going to make the one more video on that, so you guys will understand very well. So we have removed the wheel. Now I have removed the I have loosened all the bolts. I have removed all the bolts from the fork which are given for the fender. So now I'm just removing the seat, and so we'll remove the fuel tank, because we don't want any kind of a damage while working on the bike and on the cone set. So as you can see, I have removed most of the material from the headstock. The dome is almost empty, all the wiring is completely disconnected. Guys, don't worry about the wiring when you are disconnecting, because each and every wiring or the connectors are having particularly their own protocol. That means color code, company has given color code to each and every connector, so you can't fix wrong connector to wrong, you can't join together like that way. So you don't have to worry that about the wiring. but you have to worry about this assembly. Oh, here is the Allen key socket to remove the top bolt. So we will remove the fork assembly immediately. I'll just try to show you. I'm really very sorry about the light, because you don't have any choice. It's completely at night what we are doing. So if you have perfect tool, then you don't have to worry. I mean, your confidence level is always high when you have perfect tool, and if you know the procedure. Of course, tools are costly, but can't help it, because this is the way it is. So we have removed right hand side fork. These are the dust covers or fork caps or fork covers that can be removed only if you remove the headstock or the dome. Now we'll remove the handlebar as well. So these are the pinching bolts or the handle clamping bolts, and this is the foundation or the plate, handle plate, which is connected to the dome, the headlight dome. These are two big bolts which are going through this plate till the end of this dome. These bolts are basically not for the adjustment. These are only for the foundation fitment of this plate, but the main pinching bolt for the handle clamping is the below one. These are two, one and two. So those two nuts, basically not bolts, also the nuts and two studs. So this is the left hand side fork what we have removed. You have to complete the job ASAP, but perfectly, with great perfection. So we are trying our level best to complete this job at night, because we have to deliver the bike in the morning. There is a possibility that the guy is going to go for a long ride. So now we have removed everything. The symptom was rattling sound from the conset, so we are changing. There is no particular life of conset. It can get hampered very fast. There is no particular say kilometer wise or something. So 13mm nuts which are holding the, this is a very tricky portion where the nuts always get slipped very fast, because the area is very small. So while removing the handle clamps, handle clamp bolts, you have to be very careful with it. Now in Thunderbird you must have seen, I'll try to show you, just put light, some light over here now. I'm sorry, again and again I'm saying, because it's a huge problem. Now this dome nut basically is given for the adjustment purpose in Thunderbird. This is for the tightening purpose, but this is for the adjustment, stem adjustment. And the main pinching bolt, as you can see inside this, it's an Allen bolt, pinching bolt. This is holding the main stem. It is clamping. I'll show you the assembly. So once I remove the top bolt, and once I loosen this Allen bolt or the pinching bolt, the whole assembly will get disconnected. As I said, procedure for fitment of the standard is very similar to Thunderbird, but half, but this required little bit of different fitting, right? Because it's not that kind of a thing what they have given. This is a very old classic conventional type of, or kind of a classic fitment what they have given in this bike. They are still running this old technology for standard chassis. The light, once again, mobile is going to help me out in this case now. So the top dome nut, I'm going to remove this. That's it. So you will have to remove whole dome nut from the stem, and then the pinching bolt. Now the pinching bolt, you just have to make it loose. Just loosen the pinching bolt, and then the whole unit will come out. You have to remove this dome bolt completely from the assembly. There's a small washer. There's a kind of a washer over there. Yeah. So just keep it aside. Don't forget the assembly. Not tricky, basically you just have to keep it in your mind, that slight grease layer, as I can see, this is the original one. Now we have to remove the pinching bolt. It requires deep Allen socket. I'll just show you the socket now. So this is the Allen socket. This key you have to place. Okay. Just the pinching thing, what you have to make it loose. Okay. So now, if you are loosening this, then step by step you have to think about the stem also, because the whole assembly should not fall down. Let me just hold the thing for him, because otherwise the So keep the Allen key as it is in the bolt and just hammer it on the tool with the help of this rubber mallet. Reason is that it's still holding the stem from the inner side, so it won't come. So we have removed the old concert assembly. I have to remove from the fork T as well as from the dome. Now I'll show you where is the setting in this bike. Now if you look at this portion,